opportunity for all and economic growth, President Obama's theme tonight in his State of the Union address. Good evening, I'm Mike Dardis.
And good evening to you, I'm Sheree Palello. The president is calling on Congress now to raise the minimum wage for all Americans.
Today, the federal minimum wage is worth about 20% less than it was when Ronald Reagan first stood here. And Tom Harkin and George Miller have a bill to fix that by lifting the minimum wage to $10.10. It's easy to remember, 10-10. This will help families. It'll give businesses customers with more money to spend. It does not involve any new bureaucratic program. So join the rest of the country. Say yes. Give America a raise.
Jackie Canjado dives deeper with people directly affected by the minimum wage debate right here in the tri-state. Jackie.
Well, Mike and Sheree, under the president's proposal, a full-time minimum wage employee would see about a $6,000 annual raise. That's before taxes. Local workers, and small business owners agree it would have a huge impact. Good or bad? Well, it depends on who you ask.
We're not living at all. We're surviving.
24-year-old Whitney Scriber goes to school for business management. She used to work at Subway making minimum wage. And she says she almost had to give up on her studies.
I didn't have money to live. I would work about 2 weeks, and my check would last for about 2 days. So think of that. Like, I wouldn't barely have bus fare to get to work.
It's a problem President Obama wants to fix by upping the minimum wage for all workers. But some small business owners are afraid that could force them to close their doors.
It's a scary proposition.
Kenneth Cooley opened the Parkside Cafe 6 years ago.
People think it's this huge money-making machine, and it's not.
It took him 4 years to start turning a profit. He says a minimum wage hike would kill his momentum and force him to pass along the expense to his customers. He predicts the same would happen to other businesses, making the wage increase obsolete.
The cost of everything that they're going to purchase is now going to go up, and they're going to stay in that same economic position that they were before.
He says a fix would only come with the strengthening of the U.S. dollar and the creation of more living wage jobs.
That's what the president and Congress should be focusing on.
While Scriber is hoping the president's agenda prevails.
Minimum wage right now is just not livable.
Cooley says less than half of his employees make minimum wage, but he says a minimum wage hike would actually affect all of his employees because he'd have to give them all raises to keep them. Jackie Canjado, WLWT. News 5.
So here's a closer look at the numbers for you tonight for minimum wage workers. According to the U.S. Bureau of Labor, fewer than 5% of hourly workers make minimum wage today. Ohio's minimum wage is $7.95 an hour. That's above the federal law of $7.25. And according to the Associated Press tonight, nearly 2 out of 3 minimum wage workers are women.